within the day of today's video, up till now, every single video that we have made, right, from that now being specific, those videos that are on the sitting of Allah. Okay, so if you ever do now pick up the courage, now it's going to be even more specific for you. Okay, first it was a bit more open for you.
Okay.
Right? Now it's even more specific for you.
Okay.
Those videos that are on the sitting of Allah, and in particular, Ibn al-Qayyim, his Ijtima' al-Juyush al-Islamiyyah, he has lied upon the Messenger of Allah, whether knowingly or unknowingly.
Have you ever seen somebody, even the Sufis love Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah? These guys have the audacity to say that Ibn al-Qayyim has lied against Allah. I'm going to address this issue momentarily. Let me see if there's anything more to say.
That's not for us to judge. But it's a lie. And that lie has further been forwarded by this Wahhabi movement. Your Sheikh Uthaymeen, Majmu' Fatawa Rasail, Salih al-Fawzan has mentioned it, apparently his ta'liq on Ibn al-Qayyim's Muniyah, and other places, inshallah, that we are hopefully going to present. The issue is not this, who said what. The issue is, you have to do this. Discuss the sitting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with us. Whether you believe in it as a person or you don't believe in it, you cannot change the fact that your seniors, who you accept as scholars of the Sunnah, have forwarded this belief.
Okay.
Major statements, not only forwarded this belief, if you don't believe in it, they've written, you're not a Sunni, you're a Jahmite. What does that make you if you don't believe in it? So, my brothers, you, if you want to discuss, it's going to be the sitting of Allah, nothing else. Just Allah sitting. The word Julus, Qu'ud, Iqa'adullah, An-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ma'ahu ala al-Arsh.
All right, let's do this, Judas. You ready? Yalla, Bismillah, huh? تعال يا مهندس تعال تعال اوريك اللي تبيه تعال حلو listen to these now let me show you the ignorance because you guys don't know how ignorant these Diobandis are and how deceptful they are until you check this out let us see where does this idea come from اولا الثابت في حق الله تعالى هو استواءه على العرش what we have firmly approved and agreed upon is Allah's transcendence over the throne على ما يليق بجلاله وكماله سبحانه according to what is befitting his majesty and his perfection glory be to him وقد ورد ذلك في سبعة مواضع من كتاب الله this has appeared in seven different occasions in the book of Allah منها قوله تعالى إن ربكم الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض في ستة أيام ثم استوى على العرش Verily your Lord is Allah who created the heavens and the earth in six days then he rose over the throne والمشهور في تفسير الاستواء أنه العلو والارتفاع. What is famous in interpreting the term استواء is العلو والارتفاع. It is to rise above. Is to rise above and to transcend. قال البخاري في صحيحه باب وكان عرشه على الماء وهو رب العرش العظيم. قال أبو العالية استوى إلى السماء ارتفع وقال مجاهد استوى على العرش. According to Bukhari and the other scholars in Abu Aliya, the term istiwa ila sama meaning irtafa, meaning he rose towards and rose above the heavens. Ala ala arsh meaning he rose over the throne. وقال البغوي رحمه الله ثم استوى الى السماء قال ابن عباس واكثر مفسري سلف اي ارتفع الى السماء. Most of the mufassirin of the salaf, including al-Baghawi, said from Ibn Abbas, of course, that he rose towards the he rose upwards subhanahu wa ta'ala in the state of transcendence ونقله الحافظ في الفتح ها فتح الباري في شرح صحيح البخاري وقال ابو عبيده والفراء وغيرهما بنحوه and others also said the same thing واما الجلوس as for Allah sitting فقد ورد في احاديث لم تصح it has appeared in narrations that are not authentic لكن أثبته بعض السلف تفسير الاستواء. However, some of the Salaf affirmed it as an interpretation for استواء. Meaning when they wanted to understand what the word استواء means linguistically, one of the means of استواء is to sit. So that is not an additional attribute of Allah, rather this is the way they understood the attribute of استواء. كما جاء عن الإمام خارجة بن مصعب الضبعي أخرجه عبد الله بن أحمد في السنة. This is where this reference is made, and it is it is understood to have been مرفوع and therefore to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. But we don't have that particular connection to make that statement. So وأثبت الحافظ الدارقطني القعود في أبيات مشهورة له. And الحافظ الدارقطني he also confirmed the concept of sitting in poetry, verses of poetry that are famous and attributed to him. وعلى فرض ثبوت هذا اللفظ. If we were to hypothetically affirm this term, فإنه يجب اعتقاد نفي التشبيه. We have to understand it in the process, in the same manner, by negating, likening Allah to his creation. And I will say to you, ya Diobandis, ya ignoramuses, ya ignorant human beings, Allah يصلحكم ويهديكم, listen and understand. Allah Azza wa Jal speaks about descending. Allah Azza wa Jal speaks about al-maji. وَجَاءَ رَبُّكَ وَالْمَلَكُ صَفًّا صَفًّا. So the term maji is referred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in multiple occasions in the Quran. And the term nuzul is referred and attributed to Allah by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith of descending to the lowest heaven, where Allah azza wa jal asks his creation, who is asking me so I can give him, who is seeking forgiveness I may forgive him. You know the hadith, which is also authentic and it's in the sahih. And we know that Allah azza wa jal, as we Ahl Sunnah Jama'ah believe, Allah has attributes that we affirm to him, but we do not liken them to his creation, even though those attributes, some of them may be common and similar, like the ones we have, such as al-ilm al-ilm wal-basar wal-sam', whether it is dhatiyya, whether these sifat are dhatiyya or khabariyya, it doesn't matter. Because that is a big discussion among the different types of attributes, which I have explained in detail in my Aqidah al-Wasitiyah that I do on a weekly basis. I advise anyone who really wants to know what the Salaf used to believe to refer to this particular playlist on my channel. In short, brothers and sisters, the same way we affirm to Allah those attributes which apply to the creation on a level that is limited to the creation and never like that of the creator, this would be looked at in the same way. That's what Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah said, فَإِذَا عُرِفَ أَنَّ مَا وُصِفَتْ بِهِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَأَرْوَاحُ الْأَدَمِيِّينَ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْحَرَكَةِ وَالصُّعُودِ وَالنُّزُولِ غَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. When we speak about the angels or the souls of humans from movement or ascending or descending, لَا يُمَثِلْ حَرَكَةَ السَّمِ الْأَدَمِيِّينَ. Even the angels, the concept of the angels moving and ascending and descending is not likened, is not similar to that of the Adam, the children of Adam. وَغَيْرَهَا مِمَّا نَشَدُوا بِالْأَبْصَارِ فِي الدُّنْيَا. And even other aspects, other matters of the dunya where there's movement, ascending and descending, and they're not likened to those of the human beings. وَأَنَّهُ يُمْكِن فِيهَا مَا لَا يُمْكِن فِيهَا سَيْنَا دِمِينَ. And things happen there that cannot even apply to human beings. كَانَ مَا يُوصَفُ بِهِ الرَّبُّ مِنْ ذَلِكَ أَوْلَى بِالْإِمْكَانِ. So what Allah is described with in this regard is more worthy of that. وَأَبْعَدْ عَنْ مُمَثَلَةِ نُزُولَ سَمَنِ. Is even further than likening Allah to the way humans or the creation descends. So just like we say about everything, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِ شَيْءٍ. There's nothing like unto him. So we affirm whatever Allah affirmed to himself, and whatever the Prophet ﷺ affirmed to him, we don't, however, say it is like humans or like animals or like this or like that. We don't. So you look at the matter of Qu'ud, which is not established in an authentic hadith, but it is attributed to many of the Salaf. We look at it in the same way. If it were to be understood as what istiwa means, as part of the linguistic meaning of the word istiwa, then we look at it in the same way. We look at every attribute of Allah that it falls under the general umbrella of لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Until the end of the discussion that the Shaykh rahimahullah says in this particular issue. حلو. So it is never to be likened to the creation of Allah. وَالْأَقْرَبُ التَّوَقُّفْ فِي هَذَا اللَّفْظِ. But the closest thing is to withhold from using this term. لِعَدَمْ وُرُودِهِ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ صَحِيحًا. Because it doesn't appear in the kitab, in the book of Allah, and in the authentic sunnah. وَلَا فِي أَقْوَالِ الصَّحَابَةِ رَضِيَ عَنْهُمْ. Nor in the statements of the sahaba. فقال الشيخ بن عثيمين رحمه الله, who they attribute all these lies to. فأما تفسير استواء الله تعالى على عرشه باستقرار عليه. As for explaining the Allah rising over the throne, over his throne, as in Allah عز وجل resting on it or sitting on it. فهو مشهور عن السلف. It is famous among the Salaf. نقله ابن القيم في النونية. ابن القيم منشن النونية. وأما النونية as his poetry. وأما الجلوس والقعود فقد ذكره بعضهم. As for sitting, this is just the استقرار, which is not translated as sitting. As for sitting, فقد ذكره بعضهم. Some of them have mentioned it. لكن في نفسي منه شيء. But there's something within me that is not comfortable with it. والله أعلم. And Allah knows best. And this is مجموع الفتاوى, that it is attributed to the Salaf. It is attributed to the Salaf. And it is mentioned from among many. And that I will bring to you from another source, which is right here. And all this should be appearing before you. Yep. حلو. Let me make this screen bigger so you guys can see. طيب. Listen to this now. Because I got you this from the source. Here. قال الإمام عبد الله بن الإمام أحمد رحمه الله. حدثني أحمد بن سعيد أبو جعفر الدارمي قال سمعت أبي يقول سمعت خارج يقول الجهمية كفار بلغوا نساءهم أنهن طوالق وأنهن لا يحللن لأزواجهن ولا تعودوا مرضاهم ولا تشهدوا جنائزهم ثم تلا طه ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى الرحمن على العرش استوى وهل يكون الاستواء إلا بالجلوس. So this statement in the tafsir of the ayah and in negating the Jahmiyyah, his understanding was, and this is not from the Sahabi, that can istiwa be anything but sitting? Now we will see that this kalam is from the kalam of Kharija bin Zayd bin Thabit al-Ansari al-Najari al-Imam al-Tabi'i al-Kabir. Rawa lahu al-Shaykhan wa baqiyatu al-Jama'a qala Abdullah ibn al-Imam Ahmad fi kitab al-Sunnah lah. So this is now attributed to that. Again, we have the same statement being repeated to explain that this is something that was actually accepted by many of the Salaf. Who confirmed that? I'm going to show you right here. Hello? I have it. Is it this one? Hey. Naam, listen to this now. Let me also make the screen bigger for you so you can see. You can see the website. You can see everything. Hello. So the الأثر الوارد في ذلك عن مجاهد is referred to مجاهد والأصل أثر عظيم حيث مدوله والأصل أنه لا يثبت مثله إلا بخبر المعصوم عليه الصلاة والسلام. First of all, you cannot affirm it except if you have information straight from the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا أعلم أنه ثبت ذلك مرفوعا. I don't have any evidence that this was done in the sense of مرفوع meaning being referred back to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ولذا يستشكل طالب التحقيق هذا الأمر العظيم بمجرد قول مجاهد هذا. You cannot just basically rely on the statement of مجاهد. Nor can we say that he actually attributed that to Ibn Abbas as well. ولكن الأئمة I'm gonna cut. فهو من نوع المقطوع في صلاح المحدثين. It is مقطوع according to the terminology used by the أهل الحديث. ولكن الأئمة من أهل السنة يذكرونه ويقرونه. But the imams from أهل السنة they mention it and they acknowledge it. وهو مما تلقوه بالقبول and they have accepted it well. وقالوا لا ينكره إلا جهمي and they said none will deny except the Jahmites. ولا ريب أن من ينكره لتضمنه استواء الله على العرش فهو جميع حقا. Whoever denies it because he truly believes he denies the استواء of Allah like you guys do is a Jahmite for real. أما من ينكره أو يتوقف فيه لعدم الدليل الناهض لإثبات مثل هذا المعنى فلوم لا لوم عليه. As for the one who does not approve it, like our brother Irshad, like me and like many others, because there isn't any evidence that is explicit and authentic, then there's absolutely no blame on him. So we have some of the Salaf who acknowledged it, but not everybody did. And here you're gonna get it from Al-Ajuri, you have from Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah and Ibn Al-Qayyim and Ibn Kathir, as brother Irshad also shown you and proved to you from the tafsir of Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir also used a weak hadith that mentions that Allah Azza wa Jal will sit on the kursi. All of these, there's a Salaf that have affirmed that. And we still say, because it was not done and it was not per authentic hadith, we withhold. But now you're claiming that all of these people were Jahmites. And you're doing mass takfir and mass deviance on the senior of this ummah and the Salaf going all the way back to Mujahid, rahimahullah. So look, here Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah mentions, huh? إذا تبين هذا فقد حدث العلماء المرضيون وأولياءه المقبولون أن محمدا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يجلسه ربه على عرش معه. Even that idea that Allah عز وجل will place the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم on the throne with him, this has been established. روي ذلك عن روى ذلك محمد بن فضيل عن ليث عن مجاهد. There's a chain going all the way to مجاهد, and all of you should know who مجاهد is. قال ابن جرير وهذا ليس مناقضا لما استفاضت به الأحاديث من أن المقام المحمود هو الشفاعة. This does not negate what is known by multiplicity of narrations that the مقام المحمود which Allah عز وجل will send the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم with on يوم القيامة is his major intercession. المهم أن ابن القيم رحمه الله mentioned, and so we have ابن جرير الطبري and we have مجاهد and it's the call of أبي حسد الدارقطني and so on and so forth, and it was also said that this was a statement of أبي داود. So you have many of the Salaf making that statement. What else do you want? If you say, Ya Akhi, But this is likening Allah to His creation. We say, Ya Ustaz, the same way you understand Allah's face, if you only understood, and Allah's eyes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah's foot, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah's seeing, and Allah's vision, and everything that we have about Allah, the same way we understand those as being exclusive to Allah, being specific to Allah, having the sense of completeness when attributed to Allah, and they never, ever are likened or resembling Allah's creation, then you will be able to understand everything else that Allah Azza wa Jal said about Himself, including coming on the Day of Judgment, including descending to the lowest heaven, including Allah Azza wa Jal laughing, as it's also established in the authentic hadith. And the evidences are so many that I have discussed in my Aqeedah class. If you only knew, if you only read a Salafi book from cover to cover, but because you don't, and because you rely on your ignorance and what you've been taught in your Deobandi school, where you think that you know what you're talking about, but you don't know what you're talking about, you continue to rant and mock and laugh and criticize and speak without knowledge. You don't know the Arabic language. You don't even understand the basics of the Arabic language. You're absolutely clueless, brothers. And please have mercy on your souls and stop putting yourself forward and misguiding the masses. You're not qualified to be debated. You're not qualified. Even your Deobandi scholars don't allow you to be doing what you're doing. That's what I heard. I heard your own scholars are telling you to zip it already and be quiet, and they don't endorse what you're doing and all of this havoc that you're wreaking among the ranks of the Muslims. So my sincere advice to you is go learn Islam from scratch, because you don't know Islam. And hold off your tongues from continuing to mock and criticize your fellow Muslims, lest you regret it in the dunya and the akhirah. May Allah Azza wa Jal forgive me and forgive you and forgive all the Muslims, the living and the dead, and teach us what is beneficial, and show us the truth is truth and help us follow it, and show us the falsehood is falsehood and help us avoid it. Jazakumullahu khairan. There will be a part two discussing that video and that street debate. They had the mini debate that they had with a special commentary on it as well, inshallah. Until then, I leave you in Allah's protection. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.